You may be seated.
It's going to be crying at you.
It's bound to happen. Let it happen.
Yeah, come here.
You already?
Yep.
We are gathered here today in the presence of family, friends, and God Almighty to witness and celebrate the union of Jennifer and Dallas. Today, they join their lives and spirits together, affirming their love and commitment to one another forever in the form of the sacred bond of marriage. Dallas, I know my siblings and the rest of my family are thrilled to welcome you into our family, as I'm sure you and your family are for us. Dallas, you are a man of honor and integrity. Every time you're in a room, everybody's laughing, having a good time. I've never seen you sad. I've seen you cry a lot, but for all the right reasons. Mom, you raised me. You took me to my games. You took me to school. You did everything. You taught me how to be a man. And for that, I am eternally grateful. Before we begin, let's bow our heads in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day and this great gathering of friends and family. We ask that you not only help guide us through this ceremony and the evening of celebration that will follow, but that you help guide us to the soon-to-be newlywed couple through a happy and healthy marriage that honors you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Marriage is a profound and beautiful institution, a partnership of two souls who choose to walk through life hand in hand, supporting and cherishing each other all through the joys and challenges that will lie ahead. In this commitment, there lies a responsibility and opportunity for each person to love each other unconditionally, to nurture and grow together. In this pursuit of this, the couple will form a new home filled with laughter, love, and understanding. In the good book, we see in Ruth chapter 1, verses 16 and 17, a beautiful example of what marriage should be. But Ruth said, "Do not plead with me to leave you or to turn my back on you, following you wherever you go. For where you go, I will go. Where you sleep, I will sleep. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die. There I will be buried. May the Lord do so to me, and worse, if anything but death separates me from you." Jennifer and Dallas, you stand here today, ready to make your vows and pledge your lives to one another. Before we proceed, I would like to remind you in the significance of these promises you make in the form of your vows. Now, Dallas, do you take Jennifer, my mother, to be your lawfully wedded wife, to love, honor, and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better or worse, forsaking all the others as long as you may live?
I do.
Mom, do you take Dallas to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love and honor and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for better or for worse, forsaking all others as long as you both shall live?
Absolutely.
These vows that you exchange today are not to be taken lightly. They are an embodiment of your commitment to one another and the foundation of your marriage and your home before everyone here in the Almighty Lord above. As you make your vows, please repeat after me. Dallas will go first. I, Dallas, take you, Jennifer, to be my wife, my partner in life, and my one true love.
I, Dallas Browse, take you as my partner in life.
I promise to love you unconditionally, to support and encourage you in all that you do, and to always be there in times of joy and sorrow.
Encourage to support you.
You might want to read that sentence a little bit.
Okay. I promise to love you unconditionally and support you. Encourage you in all that you do. And to be there for you in times of joy and sorrow. I will respect you as an individual. I will cherish the unique bond we share. I promise to be faithful and honest, to communicate openly, and to always strive to make our relationship stronger. With you, I am complete, and I commit my heart and soul to you for the rest of the days of my life. Jennifer, please repeat after me.
Okay.
I, Jennifer, take you, Dallas, to be my husband.
Take you to be my husband.
It's all sorts of emotions.
My partner in life and my one true love.
My partner in life and my one true love.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To support and encourage you in all that I do.
To support and encourage you.
And all that you do.
Well, most of what you do.
Most of what you do. And to be there for you in times of joy and sorrow.
And to be there for times of joy and sorrow.
I will respect you as an individual.
I will respect you as an individual.
And I will cherish the unique bond we share.
And I will cherish the unique bond we share.
I promise to be faithful and honest.
I promise to be faithful and honest.
To communicate openly.
To communicate openly.
And to always strive to make our relationship stronger.
And to always strive to make our relationship stronger.
With you, I am complete.
With you, I am complete.
And I commit my heart and soul to you for the rest of all my days of my life.
And I promise to commit my heart and soul to you for the rest of our lives.
Jennifer and Dallas, will you please take out your rings?
You got yours?
Hopefully.
I do. Gotcha, thank you.
Okay, we got them. The rings you exchange today are symbols of your love and commitment to one another. They are an outward expression of the vows you have just made. As you place the ring on each other's fingers, remember that these rings are a reminder of the promises you have made and the love you share. They symbolize an undying, unbreakable ring of love. Dallas, please place the ring on my mother's finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I pledge to you my eternal love.
With this ring, I pledge you eternal love.
And fidelity as long as I may live. Jennifer, please place the ring on Dallas's finger and repeat after me.
Okay.
With this ring,
Go ahead.
With this ring, I pledge to you my eternal love.
With this ring, I pledge to you my eternal love.
And fidelity as long as I may live.
And fidelity as long as I may live.
Please join me for another prayer, everyone. Heavenly Father, we ask you for your continued blessings upon Jennifer and Dallas. May their love grow deeper with each passing day, and may their marriage reflect your love and grace. Grant them with patience, understanding, and unwavering faith in one another. Surround them with your protection and fill their hearts with joy and peace. Guide them in their journey as husband and wife, always reminding them to seek you in all things they do. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Well, by the power vested in me by the great state of Missouri and the Lord above, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Dallas, you may kiss your bride.
Yay.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Sprouse. Following this, there will be a cocktail hour-ish, followed by dinner and dancing at 7. So we will start, the people up front will go first, wedding party, and then we'll have first row go, second row, third, you guys get the point.
My shoes are hardwood floor.